March 23rd was the day Denver residents lined up outside liquor stores and pot shops, fearing they would soon close. The mayor was forced to backtrack. Alcohol and marijuana are apparently essential.
And we're being told we have to close our doors.
Lyle Tate owns Slo-Burn Cigar Lounge in Parker. Yesterday, he received a notice from Tri-County Health. His business is non-essential and needs to shut down immediately.
I support my family with this shop. If I close, it will absolutely devastate me and my family.
Tate says he's been using tape to maintain social distancing in his store and limiting just one customer at a time to his humidor.
A liquor store that can be open, Downhill Brewery behind us can be open, and I don't understand how a guy walking in and buying a beer is more of an essential to him than one of my customers coming in and buying a premium cigar.
Tri-County Health tells the problem solvers it's seeking voluntary compliance, but Tate says he's not ready to provide it. And for now, intends to stay open.
We absolutely feel like that we're in the right, and we absolutely have a fundamental right to be open and stay in business.
His nearby competitor, Smoker Friendly, received the same warning. It's decided to offer curbside carryout business. Same for Freakies, a head shop right across the street from the Slo-Burn Cigar Lounge. Neither asked Tri-County Health if that was acceptable. They're just doing it until someone calls their bluff. But Lyle says curbside delivery is a compromise he could live with.
I'll do whatever I can to stay in business, whatever that looks like.
Tri-County Health says tobacco shops are not allowed to operate as curbside delivery businesses. If they don't comply, the next order will be to shut them down. But if that happens, Lyle Tate and his attorney say they're prepared to sue. Rob Lowe, Fox 31.